remain standing for procession, anthems, and prayer. Our school candle represents the light of God. May the light of the Lord shine so ever brightly upon our schools and lead it towards truth. The Bible is the word of the Lord. May it manifest knowledge, wisdom, and peace within us. The Australian flag is symbolic of the unity of the Southern Cross. May we continue to strengthen. May our Australian identity continue to strengthen. We pray that we continue to prosper in this land we call home. The Syrian flag is a symbol of our culture. Lord, guide our nation, bless them with your grace and glory. Our church flag represents our faith and heritage. May we remain faithful to our church, its leaders and teachings. We ask all this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Oh,
I'd like to invite our Deputy Principal, Mr. Rufo, to deliver the acknowledgement of country.
Before we begin the school assembly, boys and girls, and you would know that many, many years ago, over 200 years ago, this land was owned by the Aboriginal people. And it's always good to acknowledge that. So we would like to acknowledge and pay respect to the traditional owners of the land on which we meet, the Jurak Aboriginal of our nation. It is upon this ancestral lands that St. Herbert's Assyrian Primary School is built. As we share our knowledge, teaching and learning within this school, may we also pay respect to the knowledge embedded forever within the Aboriginal of our country.
Prayer for peace in Iraq and the Middle East. At a time of war and rumours of war, we come to you, God Creator. You are the source of life and beauty and power. Your Son Jesus is the way of faith and hope and love. Your Spirit is the fire of love, the fount of wisdom and the bond of unity. You call us at all times to be witnesses to the gospel of peace, love and forgiveness. You call us at this time when war and rumours of war weigh heavily on the people of Iraq and the Middle East. Their lives are already broken by suffering and violence. We renew our acceptance of your call. We promise to work to bring the light of the gospel to those living in darkness, to bring the hope of the gospel to those living in despair, to bring the healing of the gospel to the lonely and disadvantaged, and to bring the peace of the gospel to a divided world. Amen.
Almighty and eternal God, you know the longings of men's hearts and you protect their right. In your goodness, watch over those in authority so that people everywhere may enjoy freedom, security, and peace. Amen.
Father, you guide and govern everything with order and love. Look upon the assembly of our national and world leaders and fill them with the spirit of your wisdom. May they always act in accordance with your will and their decisions before the peace and well-being of all. Amen.
Lord, make
make us instruments of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is discord, union. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. Grant that we may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen.
Good morning, His Eminence Archbishop Mademoiselle Zaya, Reverend Clergy, His Excellency the Ambassador, the Iraqi Ambassador, Mr. Muayyad Saleh, our distinguished guests, Mr. Haval Aziz Sian, Mr. Mako, the school executive, teachers and students. On behalf of the student body, we, the school captains, Chloe Yunan and my colleague, Ninel Howell, take great pleasure in welcoming you to St. Herman's Assyrian Primary School. We hope you will enjoy your time with us today.
It is with great privilege that we have been asked to speak today about an issue that is close to our hearts. To us, this is the well-being and safety of not only the indigenous Assyrians of Iraq, but the well-being of all Iraqi citizens.
We see images of displaced Iraqi people that break our hearts. And even more heart-wrenching are the images of innocent children living in tents without food, water, or sanitation. It is hard for us to understand why children, just like us, are suffering needlessly. We, the children, after all, are the future, and we are speaking on behalf of the children of Iraq, regardless of faith and culture or ethnicity. The cries of children still go unheard.
Iraq, like its diversity of natural fruit orchards, is home to many ethnic groups, including the Assyrians, that have lived in harmony with each other for thousands of years. It has shaped our history, and together we hope to shape its future. We hope and pray that our leaders work together to restore peace to our beloved Iraq. Our leaders are our role models. We look to them for strength and guidance during uncertain times. We rely upon them to keep us safe and make the right decisions.
Today, we petition our Lord through prayer that hands of peace from all groups are stretched across divisions of faith, culture, language, ethnicity, so that justice is restored in Iraq.
Once again, Your Excellency, the Ambassador of Iraq in Australia, and distinguished guest Mr. Sian, representing the Kurdistan Regional Government in Iraq, we humbly welcome you to our school. We hope you will look in our faces and recognize the rich and beautiful diversity of all the children of Iraq.
I would like to invite our school principal, Mr. Sarkis Mako, to deliver his speech.
Thank you, captains. His Eminence Archbishop Mademoiselle Zaya, AM, Reverend Clergy, His Excellency, the Iraqi Head of Mission in Australia, the Ambassador, Mr. Muayyad Saleh, our distinguished guest, Mr. Havel Aziz Sian, who is the representative of the Kurdistan Regional Government, Iraq, the school executive, teachers and students. On behalf of the St. Hermit's Assyrian Primary School community, I would like to extend a warm welcome to our special guests. We appreciate you making the time to visit our school. Students, today we at St. Hermit's are welcoming to this wonderful school His Excellency, the Iraqi Ambassador in Australia. An ambassador is a representative of a country. So His Excellency represents all of Iraq and the people of Iraq in Australia. He is like an apostle. If you recall, Christ sent out 12 apostles to the world. He is like that. He represents the people of Iraq here in Australia. And we welcome him, and we welcome his distinguished guest, Mr. Saleh, who also represents a group of people called the Kurdistani people from Iraq. Your Excellency, as you know, Mesopotamia, the land of the rivers, is known as the cradle of civilization, the land of the rivers, that is modern-day Iraq, is home to a diverse and complex tapestry of cultures, faiths, and ethnic identities that have their links and history embedded in the land. Theologically, this is the land of the biblical paradise of Eden. Humanity, all people, in a sense, have a longing to reclaim paradise. Just as the 17th century English poet John Milton wrote in his epic poem, Paradise Regained. Similarly, all peoples that have called Iraq home over the centuries have a longing to be part of this land of their forefathers. And among these people are the Assyrians, which are the remnants of a once mighty empire that ruled Mesopotamia. As a race, the Assyrians have contributed much to the advancements of society and civilization through science, astronomy, mathematics, law, agriculture, and in so many other fields. Today, I hope you get to meet some of our children, the children of the Assyrian community in Australia, that have so much to contribute to and grow into the future of the Assyrian heritage, culture, and faith, while not forgetting where they come from. We hope and pray, just as our children did, that peace will prevail in the land of Iraq, so that faiths and cultures will coexist in harmony. This is our prayer. Once again, it gives us great pleasure to welcome you both to our school, and we hope that this will be a memorable visit for you. Thank you.
Mr. Mako, I would like to invite His Excellency, Mr. Saleh, to deliver his speech.
Good morning, all. It gives me a great pleasure to be among you. His Eminence, Archbishop Marmil Zia, the representative of Kurdistan, Mr. Haval, the principal of the school, Mr. Sergis Samako, teaching staff, wonderful students. It is a great pleasure to be among you, and this is my first time, and I am very impressed and happy to see the young, the youth of Iraq are progressing with this kind of level. Students, you need to know that your grandfathers were the original dwellers of Iraq. Iraq is not called Iraq without you and your grandfathers who established Iraq. They were there before religions. And then when Christianity came, they embraced Christianity. So we are Iraq today. We always in debt to our grandfathers. And without you, Iraq would not really continue, because you are the honors of Iraq. With this great exemplary work by His Eminence Archbishop Marmilis to have a school in Australia, it is a great example for others within the Iraqi community to follow. We've been striving hard from day one, at least when I started my ambassadorial job here in Australia, to have an Iraqi school, to have Iraqi students in it. With religion, we have no borders. We can include all different people coming from different countries. And because the purpose of this life is to teach great principles which Christianity has. It is a wonderful thing to be among the youth, which we would like to see one of these days, have you come and visit your embassy in Canberra. Representation, this office, official office, representation of Iraq. The teaching staff is definitely making a great effort in teaching the youth for the future, prepare them for the future. You are the future. So we have to invest in our young kids, teaching them, direct them toward the right path. And the Archbishop is doing a wonderful job in doing all of that, and all the supporting staff in the school. I would like to say a few words in Arabic. تنطيني سرور كبير أن أكون معكم في هذا التجمع الطيب للطلبة الأعزاء ولزيارة المطران الأرشبيشب مارميلس ورئيس المدرسة وكذلك الكادر التدريسي. متمنيا لكم التوفيق في عملكم هذا ونأمل أن السفارة تقدم شيء في هذا المجال على ما تستطيع السفارة من تقديمه لهكذا إنجاز عمل رائع. متمنيا لكم التوفيق والنجاح. And I would like again to thank you for this opportunity to give me to come and speak with you and wish you all the best. Thank you very much.
I would like to invite His Eminence Marmila Zaya to address the Assembly.
Good morning. His Excellency Mr. Muayyad Saleh, the Ambassador of the Republic of Iraq, Mr. Haval Sian, representative of the Kurdistan Regional Government, Mr. Mako, principal of St. Hermes Assyrian Primary School, Mr. Rufo, deputy principal, Reverend Fathers, Father Narsay, Father Ninos, teachers, staff, boys and girls, good morning. It gives me great pleasure to, on behalf of you and on behalf of all members of the Assyrian Church of the East in Australia, whether here in Sydney, in Melbourne, or New Zealand, to welcome His Excellency the Ambassador and also Mr. Haval. This is their first visit, by the way, and this is the first visit of an Iraqi ambassador to our schools in Australia. So I'm very, very pleased that he accepted this invitation. And your presence here, Mr. Ambassador, will definitely strengthen the links between these kids here, who are most of them, some of them are born in Iraq, some of them their parents are born in Iraq, some of them their grandparents are born of Iraq. So your presence here, I believe that will strengthen that link between Australia themselves and their homeland, Iraq. These children, boys and girls, continuously pray for peace and harmony in Iraq. As we heard the speech of the captain here, Chloe, and one thing important, she said, She mentioned that they are surprised to see children in the Middle East do not have the same opportunity of peace, harmony, education that they have here in Australia. And their prayers and the prayers of members of the Assyrian Church of the East, the continuous prayer is for Iraq and for all the Middle East, that what we have here and what these kids enjoy here, the children of Iraq, the children of all Middle East will enjoy the same. And God bless them all, and we pray for Iraq's success and for the end of all wars in the Middle East. You're very welcome. Please allow me to say a few words in Arabic, since we have here the Iraqi, the Iraqi TV with us. So I will say a few words in Arabic. معالي سعادة السفير مؤيد صالح سفير جمهورية العراق في أستراليا السيد هبال عزيز سيان ممثل حكومة إقليم كردستان في أستراليا السيد مدير المدرسة الكادر التعليمي أحبتنا الطلبة والإخوة الحضور الكرام الآباء الكهنة أيضا أهلا وسهلا بكم في مدرسة الربان القديس ربان هرمز الابتدائية التي هي إحدى فروع المدارس الآشورية في سيدني التي أنشأتها كنيسة المشرق الآشورية في أستراليا من أجل خلق المزيد من التماسك والثوابت والقيم الدينية والتاريخية للمحافظة على إرثنا الحضاري وموروثنا الكنسي المشرقي وبكل افتخار من أجل عدم الانقطاع عن منابعنا التاريخية وقبول تحدي الظروف القاسرة التي وضعتنا على أعتاب الغربة من أجل تماسك أوتاد الأجيال التي تلحقنا في هويتنا وتميزنا الحضاري في معترك الغربة لضمان مستقبل لا يقهر لأبناء الجالية في أستراليا حباً بالعراق صاحب أول حضارة عرفتها البشرية وتأكيداً على انسجام مكونات العراق يحضر معنا في هنا ضيوف أعزاء ليضعوا يدهم بيد أبناء الجالية فرحاً بأفراحنا ومسرةً في مناسباتنا لترسيخ معاني التآخي الوطني والمحبة الصادقة بين العراقيين جميعاً وهي صورة مستحضرة من عمق التاريخ من عمق تاريخ التعايش المشترك في هذا البلد العريق بأصالته وفكره وثقافته وتواصله مع الآخر وهذه الخطوات الوثابة تسهم في نمو الحس الترابطي لأبناء الجالية وتجعلهم يشعرون بمعاني حضور حكومة العراق وسط المدارس الآشورية لكي لا يكون هذا الحس الوطني مغيباً عبر المسافات الفاصلة بين بغداد عبر المسافات الفاصلة بين بغداد وسيدني وإذ يستذكر طلبة المدارس الآشورية المآسي التي تطال جميع العراقيين عامة والمسيحيين منهم خاصة والتي أجبرت 120 ألف مسيحي منهم على ترك مدنهم وقراهم عنوة فإنهم يعقدون العزم على مواصلة مشوار التفوق والنجاح والتواصل مع إخوتنا في الداخل لكي يسهموا جوماً في بنائها وتطويرها من هذا المنبر المدرسي أدعو بالتوفيق والسداد في المهام الملقاة على عاتق السفارة العراقية سفارة حكومة العراق في أستراليا ونيوزيلند ولممثلية حكومة إقليم كردستان أيضاً لدورهما في مد جسور الثقة وتقوية وشائج المحبة بين الوطن والجالية لما فيه من أثر طيب على الجميع نصلي من أجل أن يكسو العراق الصفاء المشرق وأن يعم السلام في المناطق التي تشوبها الاحتقانات والتوترات نتطلع نحو عراق مزدهر بأصالته رائداً بين الأمم المتقدمة من توهج حضاراته وسواعد أبنائه مضيئاً ببصمات التآخي والتسامح حافلا بالإنجازات الكبيرة وشهرا. أهلا وسهلا. أهلا وسهلا. Thank you very much. God bless you all.
Thank you, Your Eminence. Your Excellency, Mr. Sila, and distinguished guest, Mr. Xian, on behalf of our school, it gives us great pleasure to present you with a small gift as a sign of our gratitude for your kindness in visiting our school. It has been a privilege and joy to have you here. God bless you all. This marks the end of our assembly. Please be upstanding for the departure of our official party.
Thank you.